Wildcats and anyone else who may be in the audience.
Make some noise for Antics 2014!
This year you are no longer bringing it back to the Academy right where Weldon belongs.
Now introducing one of tonight's MCs, in the purple corner, weighing in at approximately 80 pounds, soaking wet, Shivam Patel!
Watch out, guys, he's reflective. Alexander, white as snow, winter.
Hey, guess I had that one coming. We'll be your MCs for tonight, folks.
My name is Shivam Patel.
And I'm Alexander Winter.
And we'll be helping you bring the house down tonight by introducing the amazing acts on stage.
First up, we have Mr. Morrison in his last year of teaching at Weldon, directing I.E. Weldon's very own concert band.
So please, give it up for the first act of Antics 2014.
Thank you.
So, now we have an announcement from Mr. Colesterin.
So please, try to stay awake.
Good one, eh? Oh, sorry. Mr. Colesterin wasn't able to be here tonight, eh? So I'm standing in for him. I'm Principal Bob. And basically, so Colesterin, he's off at a job interview. He's looking for a promotion, eh? And apparently they think some big promotion, like they need the skills of somebody who can like spike a volleyball. So that's why they called for him. So I'm hoping to like get his job, right? I want to be the next principal of IE Weldon, right? So my purpose like tonight is to tell you my philosophical education. And then also I'm hoping that you'll vote for me when the chance comes to like get the new principal, eh? So the first thing that I figure I've got going for me, right, is like, I'm the cousin of Mr. Tamlin, right? Okay? So, like the old Mr. Tamlin, right? Not the young Mr. Tamlin. Because if it was the young Mr. Tamlin, I'd be like, I'd have the spiked hair, I'd have the skinny tie, the skinny jeans, you know? But no, it's the old Mr. Tamlin. Yeah. Okay, so like, but don't vote for me just because of Neptunism, right? Because of I'm the cousin, right? That's not fair. So I'm gonna tell you like the things. So here's what I think, for example, of like English. Should kids have to take it? No. Okay, so Mr. Simmons, for example, is always going on about a catastrophe. So I say, it doesn't matter if the catastrophe goes before the S or after the S, it's still Johnny's book, right? Right? Oh yeah, and speaking of books, oh, English, like they're all big on books, right? What's a book? Some guy goes, oh, I'm gonna make up a story that never really happened and I'm gonna tell it. Like, don't we have movies for that? Okay, so like what a big waste of time that is. Okay, so what about French? No. Oh, no. Okay. So the reason I'm saying that about French, like your French, like Madame Archambault, right? She's going like, okay, like I say maison, you say house, I say bonjour, you say hello, I say chien, chien, you say cat, you know, whatever. But like, I feel real sorry for those French submersion kids, right? Because like, they learned all those French words. Excuse me, we already got a word for that in English. What a waste of time. Okay, so now think about, let's go to geography, right? Okay, so like, I'm in my basement watching Duck Dynasty. Do I need a map to get to the fridge? I don't think so. Okay, also geography, like aren't they going on like about global warming and all that? Okay, so like, tell me, where does Mrs. Hendren live? Did she not just go through this winter in Canada? And she's talking about global warming? Come on. Okay, and also, but the one thing, I'm sorry, but I am keeping geography as a subject, just for the girls. And the reason I'm saying that, I'm driving along in the car, the wife is always wanting to stop to ask for directions, right? Mm. I figure if she had took in geography, we wouldn't need to stop. Okay. Okay, so let's move on to food and nutrition, right? I'm keeping that in also just for the girls, okay? So like, here's an example. So Mr. Alcock, he's sitting down in the basement and he's watching TV. He's watching my big gypsy wedding, and then he thinks, oh, I'm hungry. So like he calls up, wife, get me a sandwich, right? So she better know how to cook the sandwich, but the guy doesn't have to know, okay? So next, then the other thing, what about phys ed? I took phys ed like all through high school. I never needed it since, right? Okay. And also, like, it kind of depends on the floor plan at your house, like whether you need the phys ed or not, right? So take Mr. Downey, eh? Like, he's in his basement, he's watching Next Top American Model, right? And then he thinks, like, he needs a beer, right? Well, in his, like, recliner, he's got the fridge built in the side, right? So, like, he doesn't have to go anywhere. So that's why he has to need the pizette. Okay. So then also you're probably wondering, oh, how about math? Okay, so when I was in high school, like, I took functions and relations, eh? Now, I did not know that was math when I signed up for it. It doesn't sound like math now, does it? I thought that sounded a lot more funner. Okay, but, so then you got your like, logarithmy, theories, you got your polygamy, you got your sin, like, you got your cousin. So basically, I'm not for that. Here's what I say, like, to Mr. Sanderson and all the math teachers out there. I got two words for you, right? Calculator. Okay. So, like, what about, you're probably saying, oh, now Principal Bob, like, what's your take on, like, special programs, eh? Okay. Let's start with the International Bachelorette Program. Now, when I heard Weldon had that, eh, I'm like, oh, great, this school's got something going on, right? At least there's something for the kids to do, something worthwhile. It's like an international survival dating show or something, right? But then I found out it's the International Baccalaureate, so that's not what it was. But here's what I say, like, the lady running that program, like, she is not the sharpest spoon in the drawer, right? Have you ever looked in to see her desk? It's, like, piled high. Like, she might be able to find Tokyo on a map, but she cannot find her attendance on her desk. Yeah. Then the other thing you're probably going, oh, Principal Bob, what would you do in the main office? So, like, you got your vice principals, you got your attendance secretaries. Like, basically, you're trying to have, like, a bit of fun at school, right? And, like, they're just getting in the way of that. So, like, I would just have them all gone. Definitely, like, Piggott is useless. And definitely, like, Mr. Christie, like, I keep him around, but just for the cookies and the pizza. Chance comes for you guys to, like, vote for me as principal, i.e. Weldon, that you would have me as your vote. But okay, now this young person is asking, just wants to complete my resume. What school did I graduate from? I am a proud graduate of LCVI.
Just so you guys know, Principal Bob is actually Madame Thayer. And she's been in this show so many times, but something that's kind of unfortunate is that this is her last year. She's retiring this year. So let's give it up one more time for Madame Thayer. Boycotting this next act, it's because we let an LCVI student into the show. Ugh. So, I'm not really sure what to do, but the next act sure knows what they're doing. They're as good together as peanut butter and jelly, strawberries and whipped cream, milk and cookies. Wow, talking about food, I'm getting hungry. I would make myself a smoothie backstage, but last time I tried that, we had to evacuate the building. So I guess I'll be leaving the mixing to the next act, because Megan Bradley and Ali LaValle from LCBI mixed their own song. That's pretty impressive. So now, let's give a wildcat welcome to Megan Bradley and Ali LaValle performing their rendition of Somewhere Only We Know, Come Sail Away, and Falling Slowly.
Thank you. to begin. And if you have a meadow at all,
exclusive show at the Wildcat Nightclub tonight.
Yeah, I heard a special performance by Marina Simmons.
We should go check it out. They're playing my favorite song, King of the Road.
You see, I kind of signed us up to introduce the act.
And you didn't think it would be important to tell me?
Look, a panda!
Where? Hey!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Wildcat Nightclub.
We have a very special performance for you tonight.
Playing tonight is the extraordinarily talented Marina Simmons on trumpet.
And accompanying her is Nathan Bottomley, Nathan Truax, and Peter Holbrook for this performance of King of the Road.
Thank you.
Shove him? I'm confused. You boycotted the act with an LCVI student. We were fine with this one when we let the St. Thomas student into the show.
Well, you see, Xander, LCVI has the smallest, most tiniest chance of actually beating us at something, but STA, I'm not too worried about them.
Fair enough.
This next song, everybody knows.
In fact, over 300 professional singers have covered it.
Now, we're going to play a bit of a guessing game to see who knows the original artist.
If you already know the name, just keep it to yourself. Don't spoil it for the people around you.
So, you already know that a bunch of people have covered it. But the next clue is that the original artist is known for being an amazing songwriter, but a terrible singer.
And no, it's not Bob Dylan or Neil Young.
So, any guesses?
Guys, just call them out. None of this hand stuff, that's for the classroom. We don't do that here. Oh, think I heard it. Somebody say Leonard Cohen.
Well, whoever said it is right. And now we have two first-time Antics performers, Megan Connell and Liam Dow, performing Hallelujah by Leonard Cohen.
Somebody who's seen the light, it's cold and it's a broken house.
now we have a compilation of two Zed songs. The original songs feature Hayley Williams and Foxes.
Did someone say Foxes?
Foxes, as in the singer, not the animal.
Well, that was embarrassing.
Yes. Yes, it was. In fact, I'm embarrassed for you and for me for having to stand beside you.
Well, let's get back to the actual talent.
By that, I'm assuming you're talking about Holly, Adam, and Sandy, not yourself. Right, Shivam?
Yes, Sander, I'm talking about the angel that is Adam's singing voice.
No.
We can let Holly do the singing for this act. Now we have Adam Marchand, Holly Nicholson, and Sandy Murphy performing Clarity and Stay the Night by Zed.
This group has had such an enormous impact on our school and our community. They've raised over $26,000 for the Terry Fox Foundation and close to $2,000 for the Heart and Stroke Foundation. Their next big event, other than Antics, of course, will be riding the big red bike for Heart and Stroke. This group has been amazing, and once you see their act tonight, you won't be disappointed. So be prepared to watch Thomas Cruz train and examine both the I Weldon and LCVI Athletic Union to see who deserves to be recognized as Lindsay's best athletes. But who am I kidding? Weldon's gonna show LC how it's done.
Yes.
skip is kind of harsh towards LC, eh? You know, after seeing that, any LC kids in the audience might need some therapy.
Well, just so they know, I, Weldon, will not be covering any therapy costs that they have.
So, now we're going to have about a 15-minute intermission. See you back here then.
See you, folks.